About the city. Okay, so and the basic phasor diagrams, okay, as well as the constructional features. Okay, so in city I have already discussed about different portions. Okay, so like mathematical steps, how to get that phasor diagrams, okay, then operations, then equivalent circuit, everything, then phase angle, then find how to find out the ratio error and the phase angle error. Okay, then we can discuss about the different causes for error in CT, in different steps for reducing methods. Okay, different reducing method, in the reducing methods of different errors in CT means how do you reduce that phase angle error and the ratio errors. Okay, what are the different conditions are there, that I have already discussed. Okay, as well as different operational characteristics with the change of burden of the secondary side of the CT, as well as the change of power factor of the secondary side sides. Okay, all the things I have already discussed. Then I discussed about the different types of CT and the design features. Okay, some of the diagrams was there of the CT. So then some numerical problem was there, so you should solve it. Okay, so and submit it when you will submit your assignments. Okay, of that instrument transformer. So today we discuss about the basic idea of potential transformer. Like your CT, we are also designed the PT. Okay, so in simplified form, that potential transformer known as PT. Okay, so for the measurement of high voltage. Okay, and sometimes they are also used as a power measurement.
Okay. So sir, will you provide the solutions of the four questions that you gave in the previous class?
I will provide you. Please be patient with me. So definitely I will provide you. Okay,
okay sir.
So you just see about that. What are the most important features in the PT? So you know that in potential transformer, normally used for what? It is used for the measurement of voltage. Okay, so voltage power. Okay, that you can measure it. That means high voltage line is required. The high level of voltage being the steps down in the applied of the measurement of instrument. So that is your important thing. So you can observe that if the high voltage, extra high voltage line is there, directly you are using some of the measuring instruments. Okay, those who are applicable are directly taking the voltage across your AC lines. Okay, or you can say like that extra high voltage lines. Okay, so it's not possible because it is 132 kV extra high voltage line. So if you install one, if you want to install some voltmeter, okay, across your line, so it is not possible. So you have to wait for a moment. Okay, sorry, you have to design some system which having capability. Okay, which having some capability to directly measure that amount of voltage you should be stepping down, and after that you can only measure it. Okay, so from this figure you can observe that AC line is there, then VP is your primary side voltage. Okay, so load is there. So in case of PT, in CT what happened, you are directly connected in series. Okay, so in case of PT, so you are not directly connected in series, so directly you are taking from it is connected across the line. So you can observe that another one terminal is here. Okay, so you are directly connected across the line. So primary side, you know that V1 by V2 equal to N1 by N2, so voltage is directly proportional. So the ratio of that voltage directly proportional to the primary to secondary ratio. Okay, so V1 is much more higher than your V2, so definitely the turns ratio will be high in your primary side, which relative to less to the secondary side. Okay, so this is essential. Okay, so this is essential from the point of view of safety of operational personnel. Okay, so reduction in the size of the instrument and the savings of the insulation cost. Okay, so that's the reason. Okay, so what are the basic important features for that PT that I am going to be discussed. Okay, so that so you can say like that measuring devices as well as sometimes reductions of the size of the insulator. Okay, high voltage or very high voltage means it should require very high insulator, means higher values of insulator. Okay, so VAC is your secondary voltage. Okay, so here you are observing that VAC is there. Okay, so this is for the measurement only voltage. Here we are going to measure the power. Okay, so power means in case of wattmeter, two coils are mandatory. One is called that that coil is pressure coil, another one is a current coil. So current coil normally connected with the series of your load actually. So here you can observe that voltage, is you have found. So directly that voltage is measured by the pressure coil. So another portion is there, that is current coil. Current coil will be connected with your series of that line. So you are directly able to measure it, and finally you can able to measure that power. Okay, so in potential transformer, the PT use such cases operate as a voltmeter, potential coils, or the wattmeter. That is also used in the relay and the other devices for operating very high voltage lines. Okay, so that also been used because a relay, and where it is required in case of relay, so you can minimize that voltage level. Sorry, you are using, in my last as I discussed about the CT and PT, both are used as a protective, one of the important parts of the protective device, means measuring the voltage and current. Okay, then you are using it for the measurement of, and you are using those values of voltage and current for the protection purpose. Okay, so triggering of the circuit breaker. Okay, so the primary winding of the PT is connected across the high voltage line. Okay, high voltage line voltage is to be measured, and the measuring instruments are connected across the secondary of the PT. So definitely the PT is the secondary terminals. Okay, so measuring instruments are connected across the secondary of the PT. Okay, I think all of you are able to understand the features of the CT and PT, sorry, the features, important features of the PT. Okay, so you know that it is the voltage, primary voltage directly applied to the PT primary terminal. Okay, and you are able to find out the primary windings. Okay, so that is there. So for you know that pressure coil, current coil, and finally you are able to find out the power. Okay, so like your CT, you can see the phasor, sorry, equivalent circuits. Okay, why it is called equivalent? Because it is magnetically coupled. Okay, so primary and secondary winding, they are magnetically coupled, not directly electrically coupled. Okay, that's why it is called equivalent circuit. So you know that Vp is what, input applied input voltage, Ip is your primary current, so it is primary voltage. Okay, Rp is the primary side resistance, Xp is your primary side reactance. Okay, Ic is your loss component, I0 no load component, Im is magnetizing component, Rc is the loss component resistance, Xm is the reactance due to magnetization component. And you know that reverse thing will be there. Okay, in case of CT, it was Is dash. Okay, so that Is dash equals to, you know that, multiplied with N. Okay, but in case of PT, what happened? It will be will be there. Okay, so reverse thing will be there, means you know that Is by N. Okay, so Is by N means it is Is dash. Okay, so EP is your primary side induced voltage. Okay, so you know that it is phi is your flux. Okay, that induced from primary side coil to secondary side coil. Okay, so you can, I think you know about this matter. Okay, then I have already discussed in CT. So rest of the thing is simple. Okay, is similar almost. So it is RS, only changing portion is that it was N into IS. Here you can observe that it is IS by N, because reversing also happened. Okay, so rest of the things are that RS is your secondary resistance. What is your XS? XS is your secondary reactance. Okay, Is is secondary current, and these components are related to the load. Okay, so VAC is load voltage. So here you have designed, I have drawn that phasor diagram. Okay, so only for the lagging load. So again, similarly in your CT, your home assignment will be, you have to draw the phasor diagrams.
The voice is not audible.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so my side the power.
Sir, not audible, sir, again.
Again, power cut. Wow.
Wow.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so sorry for the interruption because in our department the power was not there. Okay, so that's why the connectivity, network connectivity was not there. Okay, so I think my slide is visible from your side. Am I right? Is my slide is visible from your side?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, I was in a phasor diagram of that PT. Okay. So, like your CT, the same thing, same kinds of phasor you can observe over here. So, you can say like that it's an lagging load, so lagging power factor load. So similarly you can do it for your hostel, that leading power factor load, what will be the basic calculation. So similar kinds of thing I have did for lagging power factor load. So you can say like that IS and VS, some angle is there. Okay, that IS angle is behind with the angle delta with your VS. Okay, so you are making that a reference. So phi is your reference angle. Okay, so phi is your reference angle. So you know that phi is your reference angle. So magnetizing component. So IM should be there in phase of phi. Okay, simple thing. So if IM is there, okay, so and you know that IC component, IM is your magnetizing component, so it's an inductive path. So you can say like that IC definitely loss component should be 90 degree leading with your IM. Okay, so if you add both of them, so you will get that value of I0. Okay, so excitation component. So finally you have that value of IP equal to IS by N. So IS is already there, so now you are transferring that IS to the primary side, so you are getting IS by N. Okay, so if you add both of them, you will get the value of IP. So how to get the value of ES? So ES is simple. ES is what? IS RS plus J IS XS plus VS. So you know the value of VS. Now what is IS RS? IS RS should be parallel with your IS, so this line will be parallel with your IS. Then what will be the values of J IS XS? So J IS XS will be 90 degree leading with your IS RS. So then you are adding them, so you are getting that ES. Okay, so you know the value of ES. So now in my last class I have discussed that ES, if it is your ES, so definitely cause and effect both are countering each other, so you are getting that ESEP both should be the in phase. Okay, but you know that when you are going for that VP, so it should be the transform to that side. So in your positive y axis, from negative y axis to positive y axis, that is your minus EP. Okay, so what is your VP? VP equal to simple IP RP plus JIP XP. Okay, plus EP. So you know that value of EP, it is mod EP. Okay, so so if you are able to get the value of IP, so IP RP should be the parallel with your IP. And finally, if you add some J component, so it will be 90 degrees, so it is coming J IP XP. So finally you will get the value of VP. Okay, so if you add both of the points, so you will get the value of VP. Okay, so VP is there. So I think all of you are able to understand the basic phasor diagram, and it will be rotated from left side to right side. Okay, when anti-clockwise. Okay, so like that. So now you have to find out the voltage transformations of the ratio error of the PT. So simple thing. So you have to draw the triangle. Okay, so you have to calculate the value of VP. So simple thing, you can project. Okay, so it is your IP. IP is there, so IS by N is there. Now you are transposing that in VS. Okay, so secondary side voltage is there. Okay, so it will be transferred to the second primary side, so it is coming in VS. So in case of IS, it is coming IS by N, but in case of VS, it is coming in VS. So now N, IS, RS, you can add them, so finally you will get the value of EP. EP and ES, more or less it is near about the same value. Okay, so that's why EP and ES should be the same one. Okay, so it is in IS XS plus, all the thing is transferred to the primary side. Okay, and in this triangle you can understand that. Now beta is what? Beta is in between, angle between IS and VS. So both of the cases will transfer to the primary side. So delta, delta is there, not beta. Delta is there in between NVS into IS by N. Okay. Now what is the value of now you project that IP to the x axis, so you will get that OD. Okay, OD is there, and in this side it is CD. Okay, so that angle, what will be that angle? So if it is alpha, angle is there, so now is beta plus alpha. So okay, so if it is beta, this is delta. Okay, so finally what is that value of this? This is beta minus delta, you can say like that. Alternate angle, so again that beta and delta, okay, so they have considered more or less same value. Okay, so this portion you can say like that, both of the angle more or less same. Okay, that angle is very small, that's why they have considered like that. So in this triangle ODC, so what is that? So VP equal to what? VP plus IPRP plus IPXP. You know that J factor is there. So what is the value of EP? Now EP equal to what? N into VS, okay, N into VS, or you can say like that EP equal to N into IS. Okay, so N into IS plus IPRP plus IPX. Okay, same thing, so it will be converted to a primary side. So what is the value of A to ES? ES equal to, again it is coming VS plus ISRS plus IFXS. So now the rest of the portion are same, so IPRP plus IPXP. So you can equate all of them. Finally, we will get that expression NVS plus NISRS plus NISXS plus IPRP plus IPXP. Okay, so finally, what is the value of OA? Okay, so what is the value of OA? OA equal to, this is your OA, okay. So what is your OA? C, you know that which point is A, so you can say like that it's maybe it's angle delta, so it may be the A point. Okay, so this point may be the A point. So what is the value of OA? OA equal to coming like that N into VS. Okay, so N into VS plus N into IS, that is that angle, now this angle into cos of delta, that angle is similar to your delta angle. Okay, so both are parallel, so Pythagoras theorem, both are parallel, so that angle, okay, it is similar angle, not the alternate angle, because this angle is delta, definitely it will be delta. So N into VS plus N IS RS into cos delta. Okay, am I right? Yes. Plus this portion, so it is coming rest of the portion, this one. Okay, so it will be coming like that N into ISXS plus sine delta. Okay, so rest of the portion will be there. Then after that, which portion is still pending? So it is coming IPRP cos beta. So if this angle is beta, okay, if this angle is beta, okay, so what will be that value? So it is IPXP cos beta plus IPXP sin beta. Okay, so it is IPXP cos beta plus IPXP sin theta. So what is the theta? It is your theta angle. Theta angle directly is coming from this side, so that side will be there. So it is coming IPXP sin theta. Okay, so finally you will get that value of VS, VP cos theta. So finally we will get some expression. So you have to calculate the all those things. Okay, so stage wise you have to draw the triangle and you have to equate them. Okay, so that angle, already that values is there, so A, B, C is there. Okay, so you have to find out that value. Okay, in reality the phase angle difference between difference theta is equal small. Okay, that's the sake of the simplicity, you can say like that both VP and VS reverse can be approximated to the perpendicular to J, and hence you can say like that angle OCD equals to beta, angle OCD that equals to beta, and similarly ECD, so it is your ECD, so both are nearer same. Okay, so beta and delta, so you can consider like that way. So now IP cos beta equal to what? IP cos beta, IP, it's your IP, so you know that it is your IP, so cos beta, so directly it is coming like that. IP cos beta means your OD axis. Okay, so IP cos beta means OD axis, it is coming IC. Okay, so this angle, na? So it is CD axis. Okay, CD. So CD equal to IB, cos theta equal to what? It is your I0, that portion is your I0, and rest of the portion, what is that value? That value is IS by N, so IS by N into cos delta. Okay, so it is coming like that value. Okay, so IP into sin beta is similarly same, that portion, it is IM plus IS, this is IM, up to this portion it is IM, then rest of the portion means this portion. Okay, so from this portion it is coming IS by N, IS by N into this portion, the sine delta. Okay, so it is coming like that. So finally cos theta equal to 1, and you are considering that theta is very small. Okay, so less than 1 degree. So how it is coming? So cos theta equal to 1, so very small means theta equal to 0, so cos 0 equals to 1, and Vp cos theta means Vp. Okay, so finally you can equate rest of the steps, and you will get the expressions of Vp, and you know that value of Rp, you know that equivalent series resistance refer to the primary side, capital Xp is the equivalent series reactance, and the Pt refer to the primary side. Okay, so all the things you have able to get, and finally the value of capital R is the ratio between the Vp and Vs. Okay, so it goes to coming in plus all the expressions are there. So please cross check it to your home. Okay, and you can vary that values. Okay, so here you can see that Rs is equivalent series resistance, Pt referred to the secondary side, Xs is the equivalent reactance of Pt referred to the secondary side. Okay, so these all are the primary side referred to, another one is secondary side. So both of the expressions are there, the ratio error of that R. Okay, not like error, ratio. Okay, so finally the phase angle you have to find out. Okay, like your CT, you can go for that equations, tan theta equal to AB by OA. Okay, so you know the value of expressions of AB and OA, you can replace the value, and finally you are able to find out the value of tan theta. Okay, that again theta is small, so tan theta equal to theta, you can say like that, tan theta equal to theta, you can say like that, tan theta replaced by the theta. Finally, you will get the phase angle of that PT. Okay, so calculated, these all are the calculated. So I simplify, to simplify the computation, so we have taken the assumptions of the denominator and the primary constant IP, and IS much less compared to the large value of NVS, because you know that voltage is very high, so compared to the current. Okay, those terms can be neglected, that's why some of the term might be neglected and get the simplified form. Okay, and simplified form has to be used, so you can, I think all of you able to understand the values of ratio and the potential. So part of that error, so definitely you can find out the percentage of ratio error, like your PCT, so actual minus your calculated. Okay, so actual minus your calculated, or the measured, you can say like the measured will divided by the measured. So you have to find out that all those things, and finally you can know one thing, that what are the ratio and phase angle error. So that error may be in the form of the magnitude of phase. Okay, that is occurred in the magnitude of the phase in the measured value of voltage. The error, the ratio error, the difference between the nominal ratio and the actual transformation ratio. Only the important when the measurement of voltage are to be made. The phase angle error important only while the measurement of power. Okay, so in case of power, that angle also be important. Okay, so that's why that phase angle error important for the measurement of power, and percentage of ratio also be required. So how would you reduce that value? Okay, that I already discussed in my previous discussions, that how do you reduce the error in the CT. Similarly, you can use those steps for reducing the error of PT. So what are the most important steps? So I have not elaborately discussed about it, because of that most of the portion are similar to your previous section. Okay, reducing the loss component, simple way, reducing the loss component and magnetizing component. So selection of the core material. Okay, so then the temperature, that winding resistance can be reduced, the thick conductor. So definitely that lower current, so which conductors consist of the low current, means high voltage means low current, high voltage means low current. So definitely the thickness of the conductor is less, and high current is observed in your lower voltage side. In that case, that current conductor will be much more thick, Okay. So winding leakage. Okay. Similarly, that winding leakage flux, hence the leakage reactance, can be reduced by keeping the primary and secondary winding as close as permissible from the point of view of the insulation requirement. Okay. So another issue. That's here another issue. Reducing the leakage reactance. Okay. So operational characteristics of the transformers. Okay. So you know that operational, what are the effect of the changing secondary burden at the VA rating, effect of change of power factor of the VA rating. So simple process for your, like your previous section. So if you increase that percentage of burden, okay, so directly proportional. So here you can see percentage of burden is increased. So you can see proportionally the ratio error will be increased. Okay, so it's the ratio error is proportionally increased. Okay. Similar thing you can say for the phase angle in the degree. Okay, phase angle in the degree. So secondary burden percentage will increase gradually. So definitely it is also been increased. So in case of power factor, okay, secondary power side power factor angle in degree, if you have increased, so definitely you can observe that ratio error also been initially increased, then it will be make it the steady. So in that case, the phase angle error, okay, so if you increase that power factor angle of the secondary side, so leading power factor to lagging power factor, that's why I ask you to solve that unity power factor load, lagging power factor load, I have already discussed, and leading power factor load in your classwork copy. So when you submit your module 1, so that portion is important. Okay, you need to cross check it. So as that ratio of how much changes is there. Okay, so here you can observe that initially it has in some value, then it gradually goes to the for zero. Okay, then it will be goes negative. Okay, so phase angle error goes to the negative, means changing from lagging power factor to leading power factor, such a, okay. Then the difference between, I think all of you able to understand that basic features. Okay, then design and constructional features. Okay, design and constructional features of the potential transformer. Like your CT, you can also use the similar methods. Okay, for design, for designing and the construction of the potential transformer. So the same steps you have to be mentioned. Okay, so what are the most important steps are there. Okay, so after that, most important thing is that the difference, okay, the difference is between that CT and PT. Okay, what are the most significant difference? So CT and PT, okay, so that is most important. So reduce the main power line current to measure by the nominal range of instrument, that means current steps down from the primary to secondary. So CT, normally you know that measurement of current, okay, that is used, the CT is used for measurement of current. Okay, and similarly the PT is used measurement of the voltage. So okay, so primary side current will be reduced in CT and it should be the maintained in the measurable conditions. Okay, so in case of PT, what happened, that reduce the main power of lines, okay, voltage of the measured by the normal range of instruments, and voltage is steps down from the primary to secondary. Okay, that's the issue. So you can reduce it. Okay, the primary winding CT is connected in series with the main power line to sense current. Okay, then the primary winding PT is connected across the parallel with the main power line. So CT is connected series, it's connected parallel. So then in case of CT, so primary winding has less number of turn as per the secondary. It's primary, it's inversely proportional, because I1 by I2, V1 by V2 equal to N1 by N2 equal to I2 by N1. So definitely the primary side will be lesser turn, okay, compared to the secondary side. The reversing also happened in PT. So primary turn consists of more number of turns, okay, compared to the secondary one. The CT secondary side should never be open circuited. While it is engaged, the restrict the accident for the overloading. So secondary side turning is high in case of CT. So if it is open circuit, so there is some provision for the shock, because the secondary side is open means huge voltage will be induced. Okay, so it may cause for shocking. Okay, it may cause for shock. So PT secondary can be safely open circuited when if the PT is engaged. So definitely PT secondary may be open, no problem, because lesser winding is there. Okay, lesser winding means what? Primary side higher winding, secondary side lesser winding. So there will be no possible provisions for the shock Okay, and if it is secondary, and if it is lesser winding, means if it is open, so there is some options for what? There is some options for no current flowing through the secondary side. So since the secondary voltage is always restricted by the transmission, okay, so always PT secondary is fixed. In normal convention, in Indian substation, it is normally fixed as a value is 110 volt. Okay. In many cases, such the bar type and the single primary winding type and the clamp type CT, and the primary winding is nothing but the main power conductor itself. Okay, so you are using different types of measuring devices like the CT. In all the PTs, the separate primary as well as secondary winding is necessary. Primary winding terminals are connected across the main power line. Okay. While the CT is measurement of the power, secondary winding is connected series with the current coil of the wattmeter. And PT is the measurement of the power, secondary winding is connected parallel to the pressure coil of the wattmeter. So in case of power measurement, CT and PT both should be required. That directly potential will be coming from that PT, okay, and it will be connected, that pressure coil is connected with the parallel with your PT outcome, okay. And in case of CT, that current is coming from the primary side to the secondary side, that should be the series with your wattmeter. So in case of wattmeter, both of the CT and PT is important, required. So CT is connected series with your current coil of that wattmeter, and PT is connected parallel terminals of that wattmeter's pressure coil. Okay. So I think all of you are able to understand the differences in between the CT and PT. Okay, that is very important topic. Okay, so some students ask me for that solutions of the previous problem. Okay, so you can go through that problem. Okay, so numerical problems are there, so you can understand that what is that problem. So a current transformer, okay, so a current transformer has the single turn primary and the 100 turn secondary winding. Okay, secondary winding. The secondary winding is purely resistive burden of 1.5 what draws the current with the 6 ampere. So you can easily find out that values of volt. Okay, so it is not watt, it is ohm. Okay, so this some problem is there for the conversion, so that's why it is like that watt W. It will be ohm, okay, instead of W. The magnetizing ampere turn is 60 ampere. Okay, supply frequency is 50 hertz. Core cross sectional area is 800 millimeter square. Calculate the ratio and the phase angle of the CT. Also find out the flux density of the core. Neglect the flux leakage, iron losses, and the copper losses. Okay, all are there. So from the solution, so you can understand what will be the solution. So I think you can follow the steps of the solution, neglecting the copper losses and flux leakage. Okay, so implies that the secondary winding resistance and reactance are not to be the considered. Okay, the burden is 1.5 ohm. okay, that's why that ohm will be there. Okay, both are same. And assume that what will be the secondary voltage? Secondary voltage ES, induced voltage, secondary current, and secondary burden, that is 6 into 1.9 volt. As a secondary burden is purely resistive, so if it is resistive, means there is no such angle difference between VS and IS. Okay, so the secondary current in phase with the secondary induced voltage. Okay, so current IS and E both is same in same phase, so delta value will be zero. The power factor is unit. Given the iron losses and everything is IC equals to zero, that they are considered, they neglect the flux leakage. Okay, so flux leakage, iron losses, and copper losses, that's why IC equals to zero. So I zero equal to IM, so you have to find out the value of IM. So IM equal to magnetizing MMF, that is given 60 volt divided by primary turns ratio, that is 1. So it is given 1 is there. So single turn primary, it is written single turn primary and 100 turn in secondary winding. So primary current, magnetizing current, it is coming 60 ampere. Okay, so that is also I zero, simple thing. So you have to draw the phasor diagram. So ES and IS are in same phase. Okay, so now you know that value of NIS would be the reverse one. It is NIS. So IM is there. So what is the value of IP? So we have to calculate IS, NIS plus IM. So we have to find out that NIS. Okay, so IS is 6 ampere. It is given. Okay, IS is 6 ampere. It is given that 6 ampere is already there. It is given 6 ampere. Then what is the turns ratio? N also be given. Primary side 1, secondary side 100. So what is the value of N? It will be 100 whole divided by 1. So it is coming 100. So reflected to the current, so it is N into IS. So 100 into 6, it is 600 ampere. Okay. So what is your IP? NIS whole square plus IM whole square. So it is coming 603 ampere. So actual transformer ratio is how much value? R equal to IP plus IS. Okay. So it is coming 603 by 3. It is 100.5. Okay. It is coming. Percent. Equal to tan theta, tan theta equal to IM by NIS, so tan theta, theta is there, P by B, P is IM and B is your NIS, so IM by NIS, so it is coming 60 by tan inverse 60 by 600, so finally it is coming 5.7 degree. So you know the value of ES, ES equal to 4.44 frequency means F, IM, NS, okay, so maximum flux phi M is there. Okay, you have to calculate the value that phi m max is ex by es by yeah, es by 4.44 f into ns equals to e 9 by 4.44 into 50 into 100. So it is coming 0.41 into 10 into the power minus 3 weber. So finally the given area is also be given. It is 800 millimeter square. So it is coming 800 into 10 to the power minus 6 into meter square. So finally you can use to find out the flux density. So BM. Okay, so BM equals to what? Total flux. Okay, so you know that value BM by, BM equal to phi by A. So you know the value of phi. This is your phi, phi M. Okay, maximum flux. So B equal to phi by A and BM means maximum flux BM equal to phi M by A. So A is also given. So we have to calculate. So that value is coming. Okay. So I think all of you able to find out that value. So we have to draw the phase-up diagram. Okay. So I am suggesting that all the students to solve the rest of the problem. Okay. So in some other problems are there, I will discuss in my next class. Okay. So because I have almost completed my previous session and there is some heavily raining in our institute, so anytime that power may be lost. Okay, so that's why. Okay, so I think I have completed my today's session. Okay.